Today I'll be showing you how to easily fix any system issues with iOS, iPadOS and even tvOS, but that's coming up right after this. If you're new here and want to stay up to date with the latest tech, please hit subscribe, followed by the bell. You can also keep up on Facebook, Instagram and Twitter by clicking the links in the description. So iOS is great, and while it normally works without any issues, when we do come across issues, sometimes they can be a nightmare and not even let you reset your phone. Now today we're going to be taking a look at how you can fix many issues with iOS or iPadOS devices, and how we can try and fix some of them without losing any data. Now the problems we're talking about here is a frozen iPhone, one that keeps restarting or boot looping, and one that just generally will not let you boot into iOS, meaning we can't even reset or restore the device. Whether it's just Apple logo issues, stuck in DFU mode, or you've had a crash during an update or restore, then there's normally a way that we can fix it. Now the software we'll be using today is called Ryboot iOS System Repair Tool, and it's got both free and paid tools, which are detailed more on their website. But it's a one-stop shop for fixing all iOS problems, and they've asked me to showcase it to you guys. Now they've also given me 5 license keys to give away that will give you guys full access to the software, so comment down below that you want one and I'll randomly reply to 5 comments with a key. Now act quickly on the key though, as there's no way to privately message on YouTube, so everyone is able to see it. So I've got my iPhone 12 Pro Max here, and we're going to run through a couple of scenarios where I could be having issues and need to get it fixed. Now step 1 of course is to open the Ryboot software, step 2 plug your iPhone cable into the computer, and step 3 plug the lightning cable into your iPhone, and we're done. We're now able to use all of these tools in order to get the phone repaired. Now a couple of things to note: that if your phone does boot, you will have to press trust this computer on the iPhone display, and I also came across an issue with a USB extension cable, so make sure you do plug the iPhone directly into the computer's USB. Now first of all, I recommend seeing if we can get into recovery mode. We can simply click the option for one-click recovery, and Ryboot is going to shut down the iPhone and reboot it into recovery. Now this is great, and it could even allow you to then put it into iTunes and see if that can take over and fix any issues. If that doesn't work, you can use Ryboot to take us out of recovery mode by clicking exit recovery on screen, and this is again going to reboot the iPhone. Now sometimes you'll find that just doing this alone could help with any boot issues and allow you to use the phone again. But if that didn't work, then there are some great tools in the Ryboot software that's going to fix many of the issues we come across. So if we start, you can see we've got 2 repair options available. We've got the standard repair and the deep repair. Now put simply, the standard repair will do its best to fix your issues without losing any of the phone's data, and the deep repair is for more serious scenarios where standard repair doesn't fix it, but a deep repair will reset your phone and lose all of your data. So we're going to start with the standard repair. Something to note before you do this is you must have at least 800 meg of free storage, and the process is also going to update your phone to the latest version of iOS. You must also make sure that your phone's got plenty of power, as you don't want it running out during repair, and if you do have a jailbroken device, then this process is going to unjailbreak it and put it back to normal. And of course, this is also for software faults only, and it cannot repair broken hardware. So if we go ahead and press standard repair, you can see it's got my phone details up on the top, and it's automatically selected a download path for the latest iOS firmware, so you can change this if required, but that folder is fine for me, so I'm going to click download. It's then going to download the latest OS, which you can see here is iOS 14.4.2, and at this stage it is just downloading firmware, so if your phone does boot, then you can still use it. If we then skip the download to 100%, we're then given notice that the firmware package is ready and we can begin repair. Now just click start standard repair and it will begin the repair process. Now first of all, it's going to verify the firmware is correct and has no issues, which shouldn't take long. It will then unpack the file and prepare to use it to repair the phone. Now you can see, once verified and unpacked, my iPhone has completely shut off, and it's then booted into recovery, and it's going to begin transferring and installing the latest iOS version from the computer. Now you get a progress bar on both the phone as well as the PC display, but this process can take roughly 10 minutes, so we'll just fast forward it. Once we get to the end, we get the message that standard repair has been complete on the Ryboot software, and you'll notice the iPhone restart. In a lot of cases, your iPhone is going to take a bit longer than normal to reboot, but when it does, it should hopefully be fixed, and best of all, we have not lost any data in doing this. As you can see, my phone has now rebooted and I get the swipe up to upgrade because it's now on newer software. I swipe up and we get the loading bar before it loads into the latest iOS. As you can see, it's updated and I haven't lost any data as I've still got my backgrounds with transparent widgets as well as my apps still being on this device. So great for most people and hopefully this did fix it for you, but what if that didn't work? Well, unfortunately, in that scenario, you will have to use the deep repair, which is going to result in a reset while fixing your phone. Now, when it comes to the deep repair, it's the same warning as last time, but as I said, it's also going to factory reset your phone. We're going to pretend that my phone is still not working and go through the process in deep repair. So again, I'll go ahead and click deep repair. It wants the latest firmware version, but we've already got that from the standard repair, so we can go ahead and click next and then begin the deep repair. Same as before, it's going to verify the firmware version we have and then unpack it ready to transfer to my phone. When it hits 100%, my phone then restarts and we can see on screen it's repairing the system. Again, this is going to take roughly 10 minutes, but you'll get a progress bar on both the iPhone itself as well as the Ryboot software, but again, I'll just skip this to where it's complete. Now, once finished, we get the notification that the repair is complete and your iPhone will then restart. Because this has also wiped our data, the phone is going to take a lot longer to reboot, and then when it does, we'll have all the first setup to go through, logging back into our Apple IDs and setting up things like Wi-Fi passwords. If you've got any software related issues at all though, this simple process can help get things going and get your phone 100% back to normal. Of course, sometimes it can be hard to diagnose if it's hardware or a software fault, but in those instances, then I'd recommend the standard repair as you've really got nothing to lose. But you can see my phone is up and running again and behaving as normal, so whatever your software issue is, by this point your iPhone, iPad or tvOS should be doing the same. Now, for those of you that do want to give it a try, of course I've left the links down in the description below, but as I said, some of it is free, but then some of it is paid only. Just comment down below if you do want a paid license key, and as I said, I'll select 5 comments at random and reply to them with a license key, so make sure your notifications are on and you are ready to use that code quickly. They've also given me a discount code of A7E5E that's going to give you 30% off the purchase price, and of course that discount code is down in the description as well. So again, all links are down in the description below, and that's it for today's guide, but if there's anything I've missed or you've got any questions, then just ask them in the comments and I'll get back to you as soon as I can. But thanks for watching the video. If you liked it, smash a thumbs up. If you didn't, hit the thumbs down twice, and I'll see you guys in the next one.